Yeah, man, what's up to the Gottem podcast, man? I'm your host, Brent Swinton, guys.
What's going on, y'all? It's Christian Quarantino.
Christian Quarantino, man. Hey, man, still Corona season. You feel me?
You already know. Man. You already know. Hey, I was watching today.
Yeah, we got an interview today, guys. We got Jameer Thurman playing in the XFL. You want to bring him in real quick?
Good night, guys. Drum roll, please. Yes, sir.
What's up, man?
Welcome to the show.
What's up?
Oh, man. How's it been? How's training so far during this quarantine?
It's creative.
Definitely.
What you been doing as a creative? Something new?
Just a lot of band work. Just finding using household items. I just found a friend of mine got a gym. So I've been able to lift and stuff in there. But
that's solid.
Pretty much it.
That was solid. Actually, that's actually convenient. You really lucked out because most of our guests, they've been having to climb over fences.
Yeah, they've been training in their backyard.
Yeah. I mean, that's cool too.
Yeah, hey, any way you can get it, man, you got to get it how you live. For real.
Oh, still. So
you know the draft is coming up next week.
Mm-hmm. Big day.
Big day for some. Mm-hmm. What is your next steps since the XFL is done with?
For me, I'm just playing the waiting game right now. I'm hoping another NFL opportunity comes. So I'm just being patient, waiting for the next opportunity.
So
what was your reaction when you got the news? How'd you feel?
I was surprised, especially with the bankruptcy that just happened a couple of days ago.
Right.
I was surprised this season ended. I was optimistic, and I thought that we were going to come back in like maybe 3 weeks and have like 2 games left.
Right.
But then as I got home and started seeing more and more, I'm like, it's probably not happening anymore. Right. So, I was hurt. Because I was just getting in a groove and with the two guys and stuff, and we had 5 more games left in the regular season. I thought it was going to be good, but after that, you know, it's for the better right now, yeah. You know, bigger than football. So.
Definitely.
For sure. So have you had any talk to any teams?
No, I haven't talked to any teams right now. You know, I'm just keeping up, staying in touch with my agent weekly just to see what's the next move might be, this game plan, and making sure I'm making the best move for me.
Oh, man, you been enjoying the Tory Lanez though?
Quarantine radio.
You talking about on IG? Or
yeah.
Music
release. Yeah, I enjoy it as a radio guy myself. We was like,
oh, yeah.
He definitely got it popping right now.
I've definitely been enjoying it,
y'all. And he dropped his album too.
You said what?
And his album just dropped too, so he's really on a roll.
That's why. I feel like it was good promoting on his part.
Oh,
too.
Hell yeah.
And then the music dropped, so everybody's just gonna tune into that right away.
Oh shit, he got an album out too, and I'm watching this ass on IG Live. Yeah,
he's smart. He's smart for that.
Could you imagine though? Could you imagine? Who? I would. Okay, as an athlete, I want to see AB do some stuff like that.
Antonio Brown?
Yeah.
I don't think he needs to do anything like that right now.
Imagine you see all this stuff he'd be doing, man, but imagine me having something like that.
Right. You know,
I mean, it would be wild. But I feel like he, right now, he got to focus on getting back into the game.
But
he's one of the best in the game, though.
Yeah, you're right. No question about that. But
like, you're one of the best in the game, you should be able to do some stuff like that.
True. A lot of people have been on IG Live lately, you know.
Oh, hell yeah. IG Live is good. That's going to be something. They're going to come out of the quarantine, they're going to be big. Instagram is just, they're just plotting on this right now.
Just skyrocketing right now too. Exactly. Everybody's tuned in. Everybody's just at home on their phone, so got to make the most of it.
What was your reaction when the whole coronavirus got like real serious?
when it got real serious, I mean, I just try to do what I can to help make the situation better. You know, right. I try to stay in my household, stay around people in my household as best I can. Of course, I'm going to go work out, so I'm not going to.
Gotcha.
If there's other people there, I mean, I'm just going to keep my distance a little bit. I'm not touching anybody, but I mean, I felt like it's pretty serious. I feel like we could have handled it a lot better.
Right.
But I mean, it's just things that we can do to avoid it from getting worse, and that's what I've been trying to do basically this whole time.
Yeah, a lot of people have a hard time getting the whole concept, and it's probably mm-hmm. that's what's pushing everything back right now.
Yeah, because a lot of people, they just want to get outside, be with their friends. Or they think social distancing is just, oh, I can just hang out with my friends and I'll be good. But like, who your friends going to see as well? Like. Yeah. Being around people, like I had to see I've seen my grandparents one time during this time because I don't even want to try to put them in that situation. So,
man, that damn coronavirus, man, I tell you, but it's like messing up everything, especially like, man, sports. People, it's like, yeah, like it's no sports, so it's more like we doing hypotheticals on a radio show. And I'm gonna give you a hypothetical though.
Okay.
So we have a friend. He's defending Tyrod Taylor. Mm-hmm. Do you think in this who you think could take his spot in this upcoming rookie class?
Well, I don't think Joe is gonna be fall that far. What spot are they at?
You're talking about the Chargers?
Yeah.
They're like the seventh.
Seventh? I don't think Joe's going to fall that far, first off. So he's out of the picture. I mean, they've been talking about Herbert from Oregon.
Yeah.
Who else? I mean, people trying to see if Tua's going to be healthy. That's the main thing with him. I think Tua's going to be a great quarterback. I mean,
yeah.
Thought what he did at Bama. I mean, when he was on the field, it was you already know what was going to happen. I mean, it probably will be between those two, but I still think Tyrod will be the starter because he's got that experience, and I feel like those guys are going to need a couple games under their belt. They're not just going to come in right away, especially with them having Tyrod there. It's going to be if he doesn't win games that he comes in later on down the road.
Now, how many weeks in, you know what I'm saying, like, you know, you start thinking, oh, yeah, we got to bench him. Like, you know, if he goes 0-4, 0-5, like, yeah, okay, you got to sit.
I mean, once you
draft the first three games, like, what you thinking?
Once you draft the first round quarterback, I think the pressure's already on. So,
yeah.
After two, you got the fans, you got the media, everybody in your ear asking, like, all right, let's see what he can do.
Yeah. But
I don't really know the staff like that too much. And just the decision making there, you know, it's NFL, how it goes, you know, you never know.
Right.
So, I mean, it'll be interesting to see. But, I mean, it's you never know, honestly.
Speaking of draft, who is your team?
Who's my team?
Yeah.
I don't have a team.
Oh, you don't have a team?
Whichever team signs me.
That's his team.
Alrighty, how about this? If you want to...
You gotta wait till he's out the league first.
Yeah, for sure.
If you did have a team, what team would you want to play for?
Again.
You just want to get picked up?
I just want to be in the NFL.
The Bears.
Bears?
I've been down that road before. I wouldn't mind going back, but you know.
Yeah.
I've already been down that road, so.
Oh, man. You're a small school guy, though.
Mm-hmm.
So I like when small school guys make it into the NFL and they do their thing, man. You came out of Indiana State.
Mm-hmm.
You wanna know how I knew that? I had an ex-teammate in high school. His name is Clayton Smith.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I tell you, Chris. Receivers I played with, receivers I met, that guy taught me everything about running routes. He's a nice route runner. He got some good hands. Nice hands sweat too much. he be always doing some weird things with his hands.
He got gloves now. That's not even a problem.
Jameer's been having some good hands, man. But I want to know what kind of locker room presence do you have?
Me? I mean, I'm somebody that's gonna come to work every day and get the job done. I'm not really a hoorah guy, you know. I mean, I associate and talk to teammates, of course, but I'm not a loud guy in the locker room. I'm pretty much just go in and get to work. And I mean, you're gonna get consistency out of me. You're gonna get a lot of discipline. And, you know, I'm just gonna be somebody that shows up when I'm on the field.
Another humble guy, fifth guy in a row.
That's just who I am, though. I mean,
it's been a row, man. I love it, man. I love that so much, man. Oh my goodness, fifth guy in a row. We gotta keep them coming.
Yeah, man. Good guys. The guys at work.
Yeah,
a lot of these NFL guys are for the media right now.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not a big media guy. I mean, I try to brand myself as best I can, but you know, that's just not someone. That's not who I am. So I'm not gonna try to be somebody else.
Let me ask you something. How important is marketing? Trying to get yourself, like, marketing yourself as a brand. You know what I'm saying? Like, getting your name out there. Mm-hmm. How hard is that? How is that process?
I think it's kind of difficult for me because, like, again, I'm not that type of person. I'm not trying to be in the spotlight all the time. But, you know, the people want to see you.
Exactly.
So you still got to give the people what they want to a certain extent. And I've been, I think I've been doing a good job of improving in that area lately for the past year or so.
Is that something your agent talks to you about? Like, you know, doing things out on social media or, you know, like anything like that?
No, not really. He knows that I'm kind of not really a guy that's out there like that. Right. So he doesn't really. And now if it was an issue of me doing too much, he probably would say something.
Yeah.
But I feel like the guys that really don't, I mean, they don't really pay much attention to that part.
Okay.
As long as they're not losing them money.
Right, that's what it's all about. That's what it's all about, man. As long as you're not messing with my money, we're all good.
Yeah, exactly.
That social media is a dangerous tool, though, so you gotta be careful with that.
Yeah.
I know people just get messed up by a tweet like 5 years ago.
Yeah, Twitter's trust me, it's hard.
It'll kill you.
It's hard.
Man. But it will get you, Kevin Hart, didn't he have a host of one of the award shows? And
yeah.
They found some crazy
tweets. Like 7-8 years ago.
Right.
But you got to be careful what you say.
That's true, man. Oh, Jesus, like, come on.
One little thing that can literally not, you cannot get a job for that.
Well, I'll tell you this. They did Kevin Hart wrong because of what he said, but I mean, Donald Trump called it the Chinese virus. You know what I'm saying?
He's also
you gotta work with me a little bit. Like, somebody has got to do something about him. You know what I'm saying? But he just blessed us with these checks too. So I mean, we're too mad.
Everybody's happy about that. I mean, other countries are doing the same exact thing. That's, you should be. I mean, yes, right. You should be proud of it. Yes, but that's something that should have happened anyway.
Yeah,
exactly. Like, it's a standard. That's the bare minimum that he should have done. Like,
actually, that's what people don't understand. We're actually getting played.
Yes.
But you know, people see a little bit of money, bro. They hyped
like,
up.
Like, Canada's getting $2,000 a month.
Ooh.
During this time.
That's sick. Like,
come on now. Like, granted, like, and I mean, the House Democrats just tried to come up with something as far as $2,000 a month, but I don't think that's going to fall through. Not here.
They are creating money out of thin air, but I mean, that's a lot of money.
Yeah, they not doing that.
That's a lot of money just for one state, let alone the whole nation. So, I mean,
yeah.
Especially like Cali.
I mean, LA alone, yeah, exactly. Like,
already know the deal. It's
40 million people in California. Like,
exactly.
Jameer, so I want to know something about your game also. Who do you exactly try to mimic or try to learn from exactly?
That's a tough question that I don't really have a clear cut answer, because I look at a lot of different good football players and try to take things from different people. I would say that one thing that I harp myself on when I'm on the field is trying to get turnovers. And Charles Tillman, that was on the Bears, had the peanut punch. When I was on the Bears, I tried to learn as much from the guys that played with him about that. But just trying to force turnovers at any chance I can, like any point in the game, which can change the direction of the momentum of a game. That's one thing I hard myself on, and just being a sure tackler. It's a lot of guys that are great tacklers out there. But just having an impact, I guess, like I grew up a Troy Polamalu fan, you know, just always being around the ball, making plays everywhere in the pass game, in the run game, causing turnovers, you know. It's a lot of different guys like out there on the field. I want to be as dominant as Aaron Donald, like just watching him in practice and how he goes through that like it's a game. It's, you know, just some little things that I try to put into my repertoire as well, so I can be out there and be great.
So what do you emphasize more on?
First of all, it's tackle. You know, as a linebacker, you got to be able to tackle. You got to make tackles. Yeah. So you always got to be around the ball. You know, my coach, I was in XFL, he always talked about, we make all the tackles. We are around the ball every single play. You are in the film showing that you're there. So that's the first thing is always tackling. You know, you got to be a good tackler to be in the league. So that's one of my main things for sure.
So let me ask you, when you're on the field, man, and, you know, playing linebacker, you got to be a savage. You got to be at the ball when the quarterback is handing it off to the running back. You got to be there. Mm-hmm. What drives you? What's going through your mind? Like, is there like a fire burning or something that just gets you down there? Like, what's that like? Because that's you got to be a different kind of man to play linebacker, especially Chicago.
Right.
I think it's just me. First of all, I love the game of football. So everything out on the field is always like, I'm really out here playing the game I love since I was a kid. Like, that's enough motivation in itself.
Right.
Because a lot of people don't get that opportunity. And so just making the most of every opportunity when I'm out there, just trying to do my job and make a play to help out my team, that's all I'm thinking about. I'm doing my job so we can win at the end of the day.
Yeah, I feel like a lot of, if you ask a linebacker, if you love the game of football, he's going to say yes, man. That's a guy that really loves football. For you to want to go crash down and eliminate somebody pretty much, but you got to be a different kind of monster. So kudos to you.
I appreciate that.
So what is something a scout would tell you that you needed to work on pretty much?
I would say getting off blocks faster. Sometimes I probably stay on it a little too long, but you know, it's just, that's just one thing that I can always work on. It's a lot of different things that I can work on, but getting off blocks faster would definitely be one of them. And, you know, I try to incorporate that in my workouts, just hand and eye coordination, just working on my hands, making them faster, so when I get in that situation that I can be better.
So he was on the Bears. Mm-hmm. Who was like the freakiest athlete on that squad?
Will Matt? Easily.
For real?
Easily.
I
always saw him for a short period of time, you know, because I was with them just for OTAs and the preseason. I had cut up the training camp and all that. So, but during that time, though, it's just like in practice, you see it.
Yeah.
How he is on the field. Like, it's just like, he's just a freak athlete. Like, it's ridiculous.
Wow.
Like, you have to see it to really know what I'm talking about. It's hard to explain.
Like a Bo Jackson type of athlete?
No, Bo Jackson's the greatest athlete of all time. So you can't, and it's not like that. It's not like that. But as far as football wise and just the different things that he do, it's ridiculous. Like,
Would you guys say you being with Chicago in 19? Would you guys say that was like one of the best linebacking core in the league?
I didn't play with the guys.
Right, but like just being in that group.
Yeah. I mean, those guys are definitely good. You know, Danny Rowe, of course.
Yeah. I mean, you got guys that can't even play. Even Nick.
Nick was good.
Yeah, bro. You guys had, there's a lot of depth there. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It must have been very
KPL,
hard.
KPL, Josh.
Yeah. All of that thing is stacked, boy.
It's stacked.
I mean, I was the odd man out.
how much knowledge did you gain from just being around?
I gained a lot from those guys for sure. You know, just watching, seeing them, how they watch film, right, how they go about things in practice, recognizing different things. You know, I picked up a lot of good things. I feel like it helped me during that time being there. I learned a lot from them, and yeah, I was able to translate that into this past XFL season as well.
Yeah, he was graded pretty high.
yeah, I feel like I could have done a lot better, you know.
Right.
But, you know, the season didn't even finish.
Right, yeah.
So, you know,
it was progressing.
There was like a lot of film left. Because mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure if y'all would have finished that whole entire season, at least 30 of y'all got picked up. Yeah. like that.
I mean, it's a good amount right now. So, I mean, I'm happy. I'm definitely happy for those guys, you know, because they show that it was some guys that can definitely play ball in their league. Yeah, so, yeah.
Would you say the XFL had that potential?
The potential for
be like a league.
Right there. Yeah. Yeah. Maybe not right
not,
there,
not,
but like,
not close.
Yeah, to but NFL, like, you know.
But it's definitely a league that could have been around for a definitely long time.
Right.
I mean,
it's crazy how it was so easy for the XFL to get televised and all that. Mm-hmm. But we're still watching D-League basketball on YouTube.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Like, whoa. Well,
you know, Vince McMahon, he's a businessman, so he's going to
put his product.
Vince got that money.
He's going to find a way to put his product on the big screen.
No, he has to.
Have you seen him in person?
No, I didn't get a chance to see him in person.
Ah.
How about Shane?
Yeah.
I don't think I seen him either. Mm. His son? You talking about his son?
Yeah.
Nah, the guy that jumped from...
He wasn't out there either.
Top of the roof.
Nah, he wasn't out there either. They had their own group of people that was in charge of XFL, so they was just more of the money guys.
Right. They laid off some people from the WWE.
They did?
Yeah,
I mean, it's an essential business in Florida right now. So
they laid off people, man. Would you ever see yourself doing some wrestling? Like you see Gronk, like little Gronk, just
Gronk is a champion right now.
Yeah, Gronk is a 24/7 champion. If you, that's a new title. If you never knew,
that's some fake wrestling. First off, because I actually did the real wrestling when I was younger in high school and all that. So I mean, it depends. I mean, money talks.
It definitely does.
It didn't work out, and they saw that I was part of the XFL, maybe, you know?
You're already being the system, so it's all good. Yeah,
exactly.
You've been here before. Maybe not with the WWE.
Transfer my stuff a little bit, that's all.
That's... You know, we're going to let you head out, but one more thing before you leave, man. Mm-hmm. What is some advice you can give somebody that's going through your journey right now?
Just got to be patient. Be ready. You know, you never know when you'll get that call. So you always got to prepare every day, like you can be gone the next day on another team. So just be patient. You know, just pray. And just be ready when your number's called, you know.
God always got us.
Only control what you can control. Control the controllable.
Yeah, that's good. Yep. Appreciate it every day.
Yep.
That's pretty good. Hey, man, thank you so much for coming on the Gottem Podcast, man. We'd love to have you back.
Appreciate you.
Hey, appreciate it. We're
going to keep the updates on you, man. We got the bell notification on you, so we know if you sign or not.
All right,
man. Have a great night.
Have a good one, man. God bless.
Yep.
I like that guy.
Oh, grand. Oh, I forgot
we recorded.
What was that, man?
But he, I like him, though. I like him as a guest.
Yeah, I'm tripping. Yeah, no, that was a good one, man. That was a good one.
I like him as a guest.
That was a good one.
A lot of journeyman.
Journeyman, man. Like Hassan Whiteside, damn near.
Yeah.
Hassan Whiteside's a journeyman.
Indiana State guy.
Oh, yeah. Hell yeah. The Sycamores.
Sycamores.
Sycamores. Go get him. Good guy. Chicago guy.
Yeah.
Born and bred, baby. Born and bred. Chirac, baby. Yeah. Shout out.
Good accent.
G.
You wanted Mitchell Trubisky gone.
That's wild. I had something to ask you about, though.
You forgot. It's okay.
Something was going on. I just forgot. Oh, no. You had something to ask me about Tom Brady or something? Aaron Rodgers? What?
Yeah, I did. I wanted to know, man, from you. Who will make it to the Super Bowl first in the NFC?
NFC, Super Bowl first. Rodgers, Brady.
Rodgers or Tom and Brady?
It's going to have to be Tom, bro.
You think so?
Yeah, they got it. They got it. They're gonna go a long way. They're going to go a very long way. They got weapons. The defense... You know, it's the young secondary, a young, you know, linebacking core with a lot of leadership from Levante David. But that what you're going to be scared of is that front four. You know what I'm saying? JPP, Sue, Shaquille, I mean, Vita Vea. You know what I'm saying? There's a whole lot of stuff going on. And, you know, Green Bay hasn't been known for the defense in a while. In a while. They've been struggling, so.
I don't know, man. I think Aaron Rodgers... I might have to say, A-Rod might get it done.
Yeah, no, well, this is the thing about him.
They was close last year. They wasn't close. They could have made it.
They could have. But what I saw from that Niner game was all Aaron Rodgers. It has to be more. I mean, I know you're saying A-Rod. I know you're saying Aaron Rodgers and Tom. But in order for Aaron to get there, defense has got to step it up, man. I mean, come on. Yeah. Hey, come on. You're in the same division as the Bears? Step up.
Well, I mean,
that division's known for the defense, man.
I think you can't really do anything when you don't really have a back in Green Bay.
Oh, wait.
Not like that. The running game wasn't really where it was.
They got some good backs. Those are some good backs, though.
There's some good backs, but when it comes
very
to like
underrated, very underrated. They got two solid guys.
They got two solid guys, but you got to be able to move that ball.
I mean,
the 49ers really just had their way with him.
Well, what he needed, and what he got, he needed another weapon. All they had was Davante Adams.
Yeah, they did.
Who was he? And, you know, two backs. And everybody else was just, you know, I hope I can get it. I hope you get it. When I throw the ball, I hope you catch it. Because, you know, all I got, bro.
They both got to be able to be breezed. I know Tom will, but Aaron got to be able to be breezed in the shootout. But he got to. There's no other way, bro.
Yeah. I mean, they're both gamblers. But Drew Brees is very safe with his, though.
Aaron. Hey, don't forget, but both quarterbacks got something to prove.
Yeah, they gotta get a championship before they head out.
Yeah. I'm thoroughly convinced. I don't want Drew Brees to get to
the Super Bowl. Oh, this is the thing. I was really hoping that the Saints won or the Ravens won. If the Saints are in the Super Bowl and my team isn't, or if they're in the playoffs and the team I don't like is in it, I'm gonna go with the Saints every time.
Every time.
Yeah, that's like one of those hometown. Like, you know, I got family in New Orleans, so I gotta, you know.
Oh, so it's like one of those type of things.
Yeah, I always gotta root for them.
Never.
I know you, yeah. You know, that's the thing, though. I like Atlanta. Love Atlanta. Never. Julio, Matt Ryan. I've been watching Matt Ryan since he was at Boston College.
So. True. I liked him.
I loved him. I loved him. I love Atlanta. Nice jerseys. Everything's solid. They got new jerseys, actually.
I'm not really a fan of the new jerseys.
Yeah, I saw that somebody was roasting y'all. Bad.
The Browns came in, too. Panthers. The Browns? Yeah, the Browns came in.
Yeah, I saw theirs. You can't really... Yeah, do better. Redesigning old jerseys? No. Let's get some new shit. Yeah, bro. Let's get some futuristic shit, bro. Let's go. Get creative. Look at the NBA. NBA is on. NBA jerseys are on, bro.
They got like... NBA got like a lot of jerseys.
Hella jerseys, bro. That's what's
up. They got like at least 10.
Yes. That's what's
up. Each team got 10.
Okay, you can rock those. You can't... I mean, you can. It look cool, but...
They're using years ago jerseys.
If I had a throwback Giannis jersey from like the old Bucks team, yeah. That'd be tough.
It's tough.
Or like a throwback Raptor jersey, Kawhi Leonard, the ones Vince Carter used to wear. One of those. Ooh, that's tough.
A Kawhi jersey. I don't know if I can rock a Kawhi Leonard jersey.
Rock for sure.
I could probably rock a. Alonzo Ball one.
Ooh, a throwback Alonzo Ball jersey.
Yeah, like that. Or a...
old school ones like the powder blue and the dark blue.
Come on. Yeah, a Paul Gasol.
Yeah, I can rock one of those. I rock a Memphis one. I'm gonna rock the Memphis one.
I don't know why, but I don't want to wear a Russell Westbrook or a James Harden jersey.
I wear that.
I don't know why. I wouldn't.
You know, jersey, I won't low key, I'm not gonna lie to you. Shai Gilgeous-Alexander.
You want that jersey,
bro? I want the one where you play for the Clippers too. You got, bro, like this is the scene. Like the name on the jerseys.
Yeah.
If y'all hear this, that's what I want for Christmas. If there is a Christmas Corona, Santa Corona.
You buy NFL jerseys.
NFL jerseys. Man, a Troy Polamalu jersey. That would be sick. Throwback Steelers.
Give me your top five. It doesn't matter what order, just give me your top five.
A throwback Dion. I need a throwback Dion. I need a throwback Reggie Bush when he was on the Dolphins.
Oh, you don't want the Saints one?
I have a Saints one already. I want that Dolphins one. Man. Oh, you know what? A throwback Randy Moss, Vikings.
Okay.
And just from my own personal thing, a throwback another Vikings one. Throwback Chris Carter. Just for me.
Just for you.
That's for
personal. That's a good list. I like that.
Looking at a Bo Jackson one too, but
I want a Tom Brady Buccaneers jersey.
It gotta be throwback though.
Yeah, throwback.
Gotta be the old jerseys.
Would you imagine a Tom Brady Buccaneers jersey?
Bro, that shit gonna be hard, bro.
That really blew my mind. Like a Brett Favre Jets. Jersey,
ugly as fuck. Well, that shit ugly, bro.
A Jets
burn those jersey.
I would never thought.
That shit is.
That's crazy. So I got Tom Brady's throwback.
Yeah.
LT with Adrian Thomason throwback.
The powder blue one.
Yeah, the powder blue one.
Yeah, that's nasty.
Reggie Wayne.
Okay.
Torrey Holt.
Ooh, okay.
And it's a tie. It's a tie for... trying to think. It's a tie. No, it's one. I mean, it's definitely Jerome Bettis.
Ooh.
And I want to throw back John Abraham jersey. when he played for the Falcons.
He played for the Falcons?
Yeah.
Main said Michael Vick jersey.
A Michael Vick one?
Yeah. That's a tough jersey.
You know why? You wanna know why? Because I actually have, like, the when Vick had, like, my first Vick jersey was in 03.
The Reebok ones?
Yeah.
I had one of those too.
Yeah. So I can't say a throwback.
I had a white one.
Yeah.
You had a white one?
Yeah.
Yeah, I got that shit at TJ Maxx, boy.
Yeah. No, I got mine. I got mine from TJ Maxx. Yeah. I got mine for, like, online.
Okay.
So I actually got, like, that jersey. I was like, oh shit. Hey, guess what I did? Guess my dumb. I wore it to football practice.
You wore it to football practice?
Yeah.
It's tripping. Nah, but when you wore that Vick jersey, bro, it's gonna be a good ass day.
Yeah.
Like that shit boosts your confidence up, bro. You a kid jersey, like, yeah, I got my Vick jersey. I'm
fucking out. I'm cooling. Everybody I knew had a Vick jersey, bro. I was like.
Vick jerseys go crazy. But Philly one is nasty too. That Philly one.
I didn't like the Philly one.
It got to be the throwback Philly ones though.
I definitely didn't like when he was on Pittsburgh. I didn't like that.
Oh, okay.
Because Big Ben had number 7.
Yeah, I was kind of. I mean, at that point in his career, I was like, damn, Vic.
Yeah, he should have went somewhere. Sorry.
Oh, God. But he played a long ass time, though.
Yeah,
like, we saw him as kids and as fucking teenager, bro. And he was still,
still in college. Yeah, he was still playing.
He was still balling. I'm like, this damn thing.
Still balling, bro. I was like, hey.
Stop, bro.
As long as I got a big jersey to, like, the Falcons, bro, I'm cool.
Cam Newton needs to fucking get with Mike Vick and be like, bro, how?
How you get on TV?
How did you do it for so long at such a high level? Even though he didn't go to no Super Bowl or nothing, but, like, he was still just fucking balling, bro. And he was having injuries.
Yeah.
He came back, he was still launching shit.
Yeah, that's your arm, bro. The arm don't really go away.
Unless you that's Cam Newton's downfall, though. He can't throw the ball.
Not no more.
Yeah, no. That's Michael Vick did that shit.
Vick was the truth.
That fucking left arm, that shit like it got
the man flicked it like this.
Bruh. He's like, oh yeah, he make, like, bro. He can make a goddamn basketball shot. That shit.
I'm pretty sure he can, but y'all, that's the podcast, bro. See y'all in the next installment of the Gottem Podcast. I'm your host, Grant Swinton.
You can call me Christian Quarantino.
Quarantino and thing, man. We see y'all next time on the Gottem Podcast.